Amen, amen, amen. As we come this afternoon humbly to the journey of Jesus Christ on this Good Friday, as we celebrate and acknowledge his death, as we acknowledge the humiliation, the beatings, all for us, all for us. He could have stepped away last night. He could have said, no way am I going on with this. On the request of our God, his Father, he'd done a great deed, came into Jerusalem, was celebrated by the crowds, heard Hosanna. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. He told the disciples to go and pray with him, and they couldn't stay awake. And the tears of blood that flowed down our Savior's face as he asked God to take this bitter cup away from him. But even then, he still said, yes. As he prepared for his last meal on earth with his friends, some of these friends hated him. One of them would betray him. One would deny him. Knowing all of this, he still knelt down and washed their feet. Washed their feet as a sign of the new commandment that he gave them, to love one another. To love one another. And then the hour came that he should be delivered into the hands of those that would judge him, that would beat him, that would ultimately crucify him. So on this Good Friday, we wanted to really live into the stations of Christ, the events that led up to the hour in which he would die for our sins and for the sins of the entire world. So the Stations of the Cross is a prayerful devotion that recalls the series of events leading up to Jesus' crucifixion and his burial. In the early centuries of the Christian faith, pilgrims to Jerusalem often visited the places connected to the final hours of Jesus' earthly life. I've been privileged to make that journey 3 times, and each time was different, especially with the people and the environments and the place I was in my life. It was so meaningful. It was so transformative to be in the Garden of Gethsemane, to be on the Sea of Galilee, to be at the River Jordan, to be at Peter's mother's house, and to ultimately walk the road and the journey of Jerusalem to where Jesus went through these stations of sacrifice. Over time, Christians unable to make a pilgrimage to Jerusalem developed the practice of recalling those events using images and stations to imitate the Jerusalem pilgrimage and to meditate on the final hours of Jesus' life. Disciples of Christ, siblings of Christ, I invite you to just really listen to the words, feel the agony of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, as in the old Negro gospel that says he never said a mumbling word. As they beat him, as they tried him, as they humiliated him, our Jesus said not a mumbling word, because he knew he was the sacrificial lamb, the only one that could save us from eternal death, but could raise us up to have a new relationship with God. We're so grateful to have Miss Deanna and Brother Dave with us this morning. We're so blessed to have you with us here in person and those online with us. We thank Mr. Tom Kallenberg for being with us as to live stream this wonderful place in the life of the of Christian life of God's people. And Mr. Gil Sheridan, our head usher, who's available. So we're just going to enjoy this time to be together as we celebrate and give God thanks for his only begotten Son that said yes to us. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Open to me the gates of righteousness that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. Oh, church, I will give thanks because you have answered me. You have become my salvation. This has come from the Lord.
It is marvelous.
This is the day on which the Lord has acted.
Let us shout with joy and rejoice in it.
Please save us, O Lord. Please.
O Lord, please bring success.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
We bless you from the house of the Lord.
The Lord is God. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you.
You are my God. I will extol you.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
For his steadfast love endures forever.
Oh, Lord, we are gathered here this day as your people, as those who have been called out of darkness into the marvelous light that is you. We are here only because you have loved us and been faithful across the generations, that we might be your people. And yet, we quickly confess that we are not worthy of your love. As we contemplate the cross and what it means, we are filled with joy and wonder at the sacrifice that Jesus has made to show us light in the darkness and offer us light in the midst of death. We confess that we have nothing to offer in return for this sacrifice, nothing that can match your unconditional love. We know that only love can respond to such a blessed gift. Yet we know that we are not always loving or lovable, but you remain steadfast, faithful to each and every one of us. Your love, you love us even when we are not lovable and remain steadfast in your grace that calls us to follow the examples of Jesus, who is the Christ. We are committed to that journey to be followers of the one who has given so much that we might be sons and daughters of the living God. But sometimes the journey that we take in following Jesus, who is the Christ, is not light and joy. Sometimes, oh Lord, sometimes the way is rough and dimly lit. Sometimes the darkness of light threatens to engulf the light. And so we cry out to you, O Lord, forgive us for our sometimes faltering steps. Show us more clearly the way. Shine anew the light of your presence into our lives so strongly that a new love for you will be kindled. Light within us is love beyond emotion and sentimentality. A love that is willing to lay aside all privilege and self-centeredness. Grow within us a love that is willing to surrender all our fears, all our uncertainties to you, dear God, that desires nothing more than to love us and all our beings and to love those around us with the same faithfulness in which you love your people. Now as we begin the journey of the cross, we open our hearts, we open our minds to you. We lay aside those moments, those trivialities of our life that brings ourselves into your presence. Speak to us what we must hear, and help us to hear not just the words that are spoken, but your words spoken afresh on this Good Friday within each of our hearts. First station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. When morning came, people of God, all the chief priests and elders of the people conferred together against Jesus in order to bring about his death. They bound him, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate, the governor. Pilate said to them, "Then what should I do with Jesus, who you call the Messiah?" All of them said, "Let him be crucified." So when Pilate saw that he could do nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning to take over, he took some water and washed his hands of the situation. "I am innocent," Pilate said, "of this man's blood. See to it yourselves." They flogged Jesus and handed him over to be crucified. By a perversion of justice, Almighty God, your Son was rejected and condemned to die by his own people. Grant that we may never reject his word of truth and salvation, but follow him all our days through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our second station finds Jesus carrying his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged, and the soldiers wore a crown of thorns and put it on his precious head. And they dressed him in a purple robe for royalty, and they kept coming up to him saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" and striking him in the face. So they took Jesus and carrying the cross by himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, where in Hebrew is called Golgotha. I gave my back to those who struck me.
And my cheeks to those who pulled out my beard. I did not hide my face from insults and spitting. The Lord God helps them. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my life in front, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps us.
Heavenly Father, your Son laid aside all power to take up the cross and show us the depths of your love for us. Increase our willingness to bear our own cross for love of him and for love of others through Jesus Christ our Lord. As we ask you to turn in your hymnals to 504 as we sing The Old Rugged Cross.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I change my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will sing to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. In that old rugged cross, stained with blood so divine, a wondrous beauty I see. For 'twas on that old cross Jesus suffered and died to pardon and sanctify me. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true. 'Tis shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last. I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. Justice is far from us, and righteousness does not reach us. We wait for the light, and lo, there is darkness. And for brightness, we will walk in gloom. We stumble at noon as in the twilight, among the vigorous as those we are dead. The Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no justice. He saw that there was no one and was appalled that there was no one to intervene. Hallelujah, the Lord. So his own arm brought him victory and his righteousness upheld him. Hear our Savior. Three times I appealed to the Lord about this.
I would leave me, but he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. So I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may dwell in me. Therefore, I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamities for the sake of Christ. For wherever I am weak, then I am strong.
Lord God, your Son chose to be weak before the powers of this world, and you worked your power through him. In our times of weakness, help us to turn to you, that your power may work in us also. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oh, can you imagine at this fourth station that you see Jesus? We all, in some form, have mothers. Maybe a grandmother that was a mother, or a dad that was a mother, or an aunt that was a mother. But here is Jesus with his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing by her, he said to his mother, woman, here is your son. Then he said to his beloved disciple, here is your mother. And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. Then Simon blessed them.
His mother Mary, this child was destined for the falling and rising of many in Israel,
and to be a sign
for
the people, so that the end of the cross of many will be revealed, and the sword will pierce your own soul too.
At the fifth station, Simon helps Jesus carry his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. As the soldiers led our Jesus away, they seized the man, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming from the country, and they laid the cross on him and made him carry it behind Jesus. Made him carry it for Jesus. A disciple is not above the teacher,
nor an enslaved person above the master. It is enough for the
Loving Father, you've called us into fellowship under the cross of your Son, that we might bear your love to all the world. Help us to be willing as Simon to bear the burdens of those in need, that all may be called out of the darkness into the light of your love through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At this sixth station, when Jesus felt probably lonely, there was no one to really understand what he was going through. There's a woman that comes and offers him comfort. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. Before the betrayal, a woman came to Jesus with an alabaster jar of very costly ointment, and she poured it on his head as he sat at the table. But when the disciples saw it, they were angry and said, "Why this waste? This ointment could have been sold for large, huge amount of money, and it could have been given to the poor." But Jesus, aware of this, said to them, "Why do you trouble this woman? She has performed a good service for me. By pouring this ointment on my body, she has prepared me for burial." Wrestle with that. Wrestle with Mary, not knowing why she was doing it, but Jesus knew. Then the righteous will answer him,
"Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you?" And the king will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these,
oh, hallelujah, Lord. Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it also to me." So we never know where Jesus is in the life of the world. But when we take the time to be kind, to be loving to others, so we can say, "Oh God, your Son's passion shows us that loving others holds great risks that make us tremble and reluctant to act. Strengthen us in our faith and our resolve to take those risks and see your Son in our needy brothers and sisters through Jesus Christ our Lord." Our gospel video recaps this wonderful blessing and anointing that Mary did for Jesus with the oil from her alabaster box.
The tears that made her blind. She felt such pain. Some spoke in anger, heard folks whisper, there's no place here for her kind. Still on she came, through the shame that flushed her face, until at last she knelt before his feet. And though she spoke no words, everything she said was heard. As she poured her love for the master from her box of alabaster, and I've come to pour my praise on him, like oil from Mary's alabaster box. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and I dry them with my hair. You weren't there the night he found me. You did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his love all around me. And you don't know the cost of the oil in my alabaster box. I can't forget the way life used to be. I was a prisoner to the sin that had me bound. I spent my days, poured my life without measure into a little treasure box I thought I found. Until the day when Jesus came to me and healed my soul with the wonder of his touch. So now I'm giving back to him all the praise he's worthy of. I've been forgiven, and that's why don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and dry them with my hair. My hair, you are there. The night Jesus found me, you did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his loving arms around me.
Imagine giving the best that you have to Jesus. Our seventh station finds Jesus falling a second time. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God and afflicted. But he was wounded, church, for our transgression, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole. And by his bruises, we are truly healed. All are we like sheep, have grown astray. We have all turned to our own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquities of all of us. Blessed are the poor in spirit.
For theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are you, the people who lie on the earth, and utter all kinds of evil against you, falsely by my account. Rejoice and be glad.
Oh, and we can pray, gracious Lord, as we walk the way of sorrow. It pains us to know that it is our failingness and sin that crushes Jesus under his cross. Yet by his suffering, we are raised up and made whole. Strengthen us in our baptismal vows. But, oh Lord, forgive us always for the sins that make us fall for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. The women of Jerusalem meets us at the eighth station. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
A great number of the people followed him, and among them were women who were beating their breasts and wailing for him. But Jesus turned to them and said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children." Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. God, our Father, of Lord Jesus Christ, we are but mortal flesh, and the span of our lives is very brief, people of God. Help us to see our frailty and afflictions as a sharing in Christ's frailty and affliction, and through them the path to life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. For the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Jesus fell a third time. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
I cry to God, Most High, to God who fulfills his purpose for me. I lie down among lions that greedily devour human prey. Their teeth are spears and arrows. Their tongues are sharp swords. They set a net for my steps. My soul bowed down. They dug a pit in my path, but they have fallen into it themselves. Oh, my heart is steadfast. Oh, God, my heart is steadfast. My God,
it is melted within my breast. My mouth is dried up.
Almighty God, there are times when life's burdens, hallelujah, weighs down upon us. And our faith is so drained that we feel forsaken and abandoned by you. Yet, you never forsake those who are your own. As you raise your son from death to life, from despair to joy, please be present in our lives and raise us to hope in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We ask you to turn, it's hymn number, that's a dumb place there.
2162 in the black.
And the hat, oh yeah, there you go. 2162. Apologies for that error. As we know that it's grace alone that has us every day, that keeps us going every day, that precious grace that God just showers upon us over and over and over again. Amen.
Every promise we can make, every prayer and step of faith, every difference we will make is only by His grace. Every mountain we will climb, every ray of hope we shine, every blessing left behind is only by His grace. Grace alone, which God supplies, strength unknown, He will provide. Christ in us, our cornerstone, we will go forth in grace alone. Every soul we long to reach, every heart we hope to teach, everywhere we share His peace is only by His grace. Every loving word we say, every tear we wipe away, every sorrow turned to praise is only by His grace. Grace alone, which God supplies, strength unknown, He will provide. Christ in us, our cornerstone, we will go forth in grace alone.
At the 10th station, we find just more cruelty towards our Jesus as they strip Him of His clothes. And sometimes, even for us, that is our dignity. As we take the time to dress appropriately, or we want to look a certain way, and to have that taken away violently is hurtful, is painful. But Jesus said yes. Jesus said yes. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took His clothes and divided them into four parts, one for each soldier. They also took His tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top. So they said to one another, let's not tear this tunic, this piece of cloth. Let's cast lots to see who will get it. Let's gamble. Let's roll some dice and see who's going to get this tunic. all of you must clothe yourself with humility.
In your dealings with one another, for God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Amen. Lord God, your Son endured humiliations and indignities beyond compare, beyond anything that we would ever be able to endure. Yet without complaint, yet without a mumbling word, keep us humble in our work, in our daily lives, with the willingness to put others before ourselves as Jesus put us before himself through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We get to the hour where Jesus is nailed to the cross at the 11th station. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Now, there were two other criminals that were led away to be put to death along with Jesus on that Good Friday. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified him with these criminals, one on the right and one on the left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." When we were dead in trespasses,
God made us alive together with him. When he forgave us all our trespasses, erasing the record that stood against us with its evil demands,
he set it aside,
nailing it to the cross.
Amen, amen. Heavenly Father, despite his wounds, Jesus showed his love throughout his passion. Though they were beating him, though they were flogging him, though they were treating him as a criminal, the people had cried, "Crucify him, crucify him." And Jesus said nothing. He showed his love for us, for his mother, for the women of Jerusalem, for the good thief, even for those who were nailing him, banging the nail through the flesh and bones of his feet and of his hands as they stretched him wide on that rugged cross. Our Jesus said nothing. Our Jesus said nothing. In his darkest hours, he said nothing. We ask that you bind us ever to that love, that unconditional love, that agape love, and help us to look beyond ourselves and our own suffering in order to share Jesus' love with others through Jesus Christ our Lord. Oh, they say that it grew dark like midnight, and yet the sun was shining bright at that noon hour. When Jesus gave it all up, and died. So our 12th station finds our Savior, finds this human yet divine person hanging on the rugged cross, hanging there for the first hour, the second hour, the third and fourth and fifth hour, the sixth hour, the seventh hour, the eighth hour. But on that ninth hour, in that ninth hour, into your hands, Father, I commit my spirit. So we find Jesus dying on that rugged cross for you and I. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. Now, people of God, it is about noon, and darkness came over the whole world until 3 p.m. while the sunlight failed and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, Father, into your hand I commend my spirit. Church, listen. He'd taken it all and never said anything. He'd taken it all for you and I. He took it all that we could have life eternal. He took it all. But he was still human, yet divine. And as our earthly bodies get to a point to where it can't go on anymore, the earthly part of Jesus knew that it was the end. And he said, Father, Father, I know that death is here now. I know I'm going to die now. But I'm not like regular humans. I send my spirit back to you. Back to you. But I will die this earthly human death for your greatest creation, your people, that they may have new life, a new relationship with you through my death. When you make his life an offering for sin, us is why he did that. Who would have believed it, oh God? Who would have thought that the Savior would die? Yet in the world's darkest hour, you snatched him out of the jaws of death, crushing sin and death underfoot. Keep us ever close to the cross and death. Now and at the hour of our own death, our earthly death, through Jesus Christ our Lord. My friends in Christ, it was the blood. It was the precious blood of Jesus. It's why we are here today. If it hadn't been for the shedding of his precious blood, the blood of the Lamb of God, we would have no place with God. God said that he looked around high and low to find someone that could shed blood for the redemption of God's greatest creation, humanity. Gabriel couldn't do it. Moses couldn't do it. Elijah couldn't do it. David couldn't do it. And he kept searching and searching and searching until he heard in heaven a voice say, Father, I will go. I will go for the salvation of your people. And it was only Jesus and his precious blood that was shed on this Good Friday that gave us an opportunity to be reconciled with our God. So church, as we hear this beautiful gospel song, I thank God for the blood that came streaming down on long ago Good Friday, that made an opportunity for us to have a relationship, a new relationship with God.
Precious blood that made the difference at Calvary. Oh, the blood. That precious blood that my Savior it shed for me. I thank God for the blood that came streaming down for me. The blood that made the difference at Calvary. Since I've been washed in Jesus' blood, all of my sins are gone away. No more shame. I'm not the same. My awful debt with this blood he did pay. Ever made such a sacrifice, such a sacrifice for me. It was the blood made the difference and Calvary. Thank you. Daddy Shay, way back on Calvary. He never said a mumbling word. They put an old heavy rugged cross on his shoulder, and they made him march up a rugged hill called Calvary. They spit in his face. They threw stones at him. They mocked. They pierced his hands. They pierced his side. And the scripture said the blood came streaming down. The precious blood of the Lamb of God came streaming down.
Hallelujah, Lord. We thank you for the blood. We thank you for the only sacrifice that could save a sin-sick world. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. The 13th station finds that Jesus is taken down from his cross. When evening is come, and since it was a day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council who was himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for the body of our Jesus. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, Pilate granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph brought a linen cloth and taken down his precious body, his broken body, his wounded body, and wrapped him in the linen cloth. I will pour out a spirit of compassion. Yes, Lord.
And weep bitterly over him as one weeps over a firstborn.
Gracious God and counselor of all who mourn, comfort us in our parting. Turn the darkness of death into the brightness of day for those we love. Help us always to put our faith in you and entrust our loved ones into your infinite care through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We're going to lie our precious Jesus in a tomb, a borrowed tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. Hear this, people of God. Nicodemus, who had first come to Jesus by night, also came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, weighing about 100 pounds. 100 pounds of anointing oils. He and Joseph took the body of Jesus and wrapped it with the spices and linen cloth according to the burial customs of the Jews. Now there was a garden in the place where Jesus was crucified, and in the garden there was a new tomb in which no one had ever been laid. And so because it was the Jewish day of preparation and the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus there. Thus say the Lord God.
Bring you back to the land of Israel, and you shall
God of hope, you have promised that if we are buried with Christ in the waters of baptism, then we too will rise with him in a new life. Make us ever mindful of our baptism and remove all stains of sin from us through repentance for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Is finished, the Messiah dies, cut off for sins, but not his own. Accomplished is the sacrifice, the great redeeming work is done. The veil is rent in Christ alone, the living way to heaven is seen. The middle wall is broken down, and all the world may is finished all the guilt and pain. I want no sacrifice beside. For me, the Lamb is slain. 'Tis finished. 'Tis finished. 'Tis finished. I am justified. The reign of sin and death is o'er, and all may live from sin set free. Death has lost its mortal power, it's swallowed up in victory. Tis finished, tis finished, tis finished, tis finished. Is finished. I am justified.
Amen. Far be it for me to glory. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, people of God, who though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God or something to be exploited. But our Jesus emptied himself, taking the form of an enslaved person, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, Jesus humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. With that assurance, we can pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Almighty God, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, and for the gift of our salvation that he won for us through the way of the cross. Make our path straight and keep our feet upon the way of the cross until you bring us safely into your heavenly kingdom, where you reign with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. People of God, let us follow Jesus all the way to the cross.
Until our lives end.
We pray that you will come early on Sunday morning when we will celebrate prayerfully once again. The tomb is empty. The tomb is empty. All power and glory is Jesus, now and forever. We pray that you will come join us for a Southern Midwestern breakfast at 8 a.m. And with uplifting music, the word of God, and repeated hallelujahs, that we will celebrate our risen Lord at our 9:30 worship service. Go in peace, go in love, on this, your Good Friday, for your Savior said yes. Your Savior said yes. Amen.